of x is also differentiable at x equal to a, then what can we comment on the sum of these two functions? Will it be differentiable?
Yes.
Yes, it's differentiable at x equal to a. Same would hold true for difference as well. So I'm writing it in one go. Can I say the same for product as well? Product will also be differentiable at x equal to a. Now these properties actually will make our life very simple in competitive exams questions, because we don't have to do those differentiation, for example, in the previous questions. We don't have to sit and do the differentiation in order to know that my left hand derivative and my right hand derivative are equal or not. And same would hold true even for quotient of these two functions, provided
g of x is not equal to
a. Yes, provided your g of a is not 0. Is that right? This property you will find in almost every book. But what they don't discuss are the properties which are going to come next. When a function is differentiable at a and another is not differentiable at a, then what happens? Let's discuss that. Does this need any debate or a discussion? I don't think so. It's very obvious. Property number 5. If f of x is differentiable at x equal to a and g of x is not differentiable at x equal to a. Okay. Then what can you comment about the sum of f of x and g of x? Will it be differentiable? Or will it be never be differentiable at x equal to a? Or can't say?
It won't be differentiable at x.
Shiram is saying it will definitely not be differentiable at x equal to a.
Not necessarily.
Then give me an example where a differentiable and a non-differentiable gives you differentiable.
So, oh, only the previous question, right? X plus 1 into what a I am.
So, it is differentiable.
X plus 1.
X plus 1.
It's a plus, not multiplication.
So it's not differentiable.
Not differentiable.
So if there is a king for example, if there is a king and there is a common thing when you add them, there has to be a king somewhere.
No.
You take back your words. You retract your message.
I was talking about something else.
It is not differentiable.
What is the case for x equal to 0?
Okay. It's very obvious because when you're finding the derivative through limits, one of them will give you two different limits. Correct? Yes or no? And so the entire limit also will be two different limits will come up. Correct? So left hand derivative and right hand derivative for the entire function will give you two values, hence no unique tangent at that point. What can we comment on their product?
It is differentiable.
Just now we had discussed x and mod x. Correct? It is differentiable at 0. So here, we cannot say anything. So, product of a.
Plus or minus.
So, for product of a function, you may end up getting a differentiable function also for a product of a differentiable and a non differentiable at that very point x equal to a. Okay, give me an example where a differentiable function at x equal to a multiplies to a non-differentiable function at x equal to a to produce a non-differentiable function at x equal to a.
Our previous question.
We say constant in tan.
Our previous question at x equal to
constant in tan.
Sir, where did it go?
Tell me an example of a function which is differentiable at x equal to a and another function which is not differentiable at x equal to a, and when you multiply it, you get a non-differentiable at x equal to a.
So mod x minus 2 into sine x.
Mod x minus 2 into sine x, which point is it?
2.
At 2. Can you please all check in the graph? It has to be correct. It has to be correct. He said mod x minus 2 into sine x. So sin x is differentiable at 2, mod x minus 2 is not differentiable at x equal to 2, and when you multiply it, you will get a sharp change in the direction, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
Yes. Okay. Friends, I have a question for all of you. In fact, I have a claim. Try to see whether that claim is correct or not. Okay. F of x is cos x, let's say. We know it's differentiable at pi by 2, right? Correct? G of x is tan x. We know it's not differentiable at pi by 2, correct? Yes, sir? When I multiply it, I get sine of x, correct? Which is differentiable at pi by 2. Is this correct? Is there anything wrong or is there anything fallacy in my assertion that the product of this gives you this, which is a differentiable at pi by 2? Very deep question. I mean, people take it on its face well. Is this claim correct that if these two functions are multiplied, I get a sine x? This was differentiable at pi by 2, this was not differentiable at pi by 2, and this is actually differentiable at pi by 2. Is this correct? Is this correct that this sine x that you have obtained by multiplying these two, is it differentiable at pi by 2? I multiplied these two and I got this.
Yeah.
Is it differentiable at pi by 2?
Yeah.
The answer is...
One.
It's a wrong statement. No, it's very surprising because... Okay, now see here, the catch is... The domain of g of x doesn't include pi by 2. Correct? Right? The non-differentiability here was because of its undefined nature at pi by 2. Correct? So when you multiply two functions, we take their overlapping domain. Correct? That means even pi by 2 is not in the domain of sine x. So ideally there should have been a hole there. Meant with a hole. Yes or no? Ideally, this sine x would not be a normal sine x, it will actually be a sine x like this. Tuck. Are you getting this point? In fact, we'll have a hole at 3 pi by 2 as well. Even though superficially it is a sine curve, but with hole at static points. You know that hole is because of the fact that the functions making that sine x did not exist. Are you getting it? And this is a fundamental error which people make. They do not consider the functions which were used to make this function. They just take it on its face value. Okay, sine x, continuous everywhere, differentiable everywhere, done. But the moment I say...
Sorry, this is x.
The moment... The moment I say my sine x is made up of cos x into tan x, because pi by 2 is not in the domain of tan x, it will also be not in the domain of sine x. And if some point is not in the domain, how can you talk about differentiability there, because it will be discontinuous there. And hence it will not be differentiable there. So this statement, is it correct? No. Be careful of these small conceptual testings that can be asked to you. Six or seven?
Six. Six. Cos pi by 2 has a value of 1 in the domain. Which is.
Yes.
So,
but tan doesn't have.
Both need to have.
Both need to have. The domain of the resultant function would be an overlap of the domain of the two functions making it. Not only in case of multiplication, but also in the case of sum. And also in the case of division. In division, we exclude extra points because you do not allow your denominator to become zero. Remember in the domain chapter last year, I talked about this concept. If I want to find domain of f of x by g of x, domain of f of x by g of x would be nothing but, let's say the domain of this is d1, domain of this is d2. What is the domain of this resultant function? D1 intersection D2, excluding those points where g of x is becoming 0. This I did last year with you. So not only we take the overlapping of these two, but in addition to that, we exclude such points where denominator is becoming 0. Because denominator, 0 points will also be in its domain, right? Right? Because if you see at g of x, there is no harm in it becoming 0. So those points will also come in its domain. But overall in this scenario, those points should not be entertained. Make sense?
How do you wipe this complete thing off in one go?
So if you don't have page.
No.
Keep on
editing. I don't
want to waste time. Keep on editing. Keep on editing. Like this will be like,
clear. Slide it. No, slide it.
Clear.
Okay. Next property. If f of x is not differentiable at x equal to a, and g of x is also not differentiable at x equal to a, what can we comment on the sum of these two functions? Or for that matter,
not differentiable.
Everybody?
Yeah.
One voice? Not differentiable. Okay. I have a scenario for you.
I didn't say anything.
Okay, let's say sine of mod x. We know it's non-differentiable at 0. All of you please check this on your desktops. Sine mod x.
Yeah.
You know that sine curve. Correct? This is a brand by that symbol, no? Something like this. I've seen some t-shirts in that brand. It looks like this.
Is it big?
Monster is all the scratches and all.
No, it's over the mustache. Mustache.
So do you see there is a dust form over 0, right? So it is not differentiable there. Yes or no? Agreed? Okay. Let me take another function. Negative mod x. This is also not differentiable at 0. How is the graph of negative mod x? Ulta, right?
So can't say the answer is can't say.
Yes, yeah,
not. Now you are saying can't say.
Oh,
that time you can't say. Okay. When you add it, please plot this.
It's not differentiable.
It's
not plotting.
You multiply it.
So it is differentiable.
It is.
Yeah, did you see? That is differentiable. A mountain, smooth mountain getting formed.
Yeah. Oh yeah.
Correct?
Yeah.
Do you see that sudden change in direction for both of them has been smoothened out?
Yeah.
Right? And this function is differentiable at x equal to 0. So do you take back your claim that you'll always get a non-differentiable function? What's the moral of the story?
Can't say.
Okay. Now why I'm giving you all these cases is because many a time such questions come and people, okay, two non-differentiable functions, they'll always add up to give you non-differentiable functions.
No.
Cannot say. That depends upon the question itself. And the very same function, if you add them, sine mod x plus mod x, if you do, you see that it is non-differentiable at 0.
Yeah.
Plot the graph, see there is a sharp corner. Right? So it will come like this, some from bottom like this will come.
Yeah.
What about their multiplication? What about their product?
No, wait.
No, I'll wait for him to say first.
It is.
No, it's not.
So it's already differentiable, or it's already differentiable,
or can't say.
I'm talking in
general.
Can't say. Prithvi.
Can't say.
How many of you have it installed response yet on your phones?
I don't have
Facebook to... app you will download like this or not.
Sir, I have a good
thing you will not download. Yes, what do you say? I am waiting for you.
Can't say.
You are right. But give me an example. I know you can give me hundreds of examples where the product will be non-differentiable. Give me an example where two non-differentiable functions at a point x equal to a multiply to give me a differentiable function at a point.
Sine mod x into mod x. Same one. Sine mod x into mod x.
Sine mod x into mod x.
Same function. Yeah. It gives this.
Correct. Oh wow. Correct. Other example would be this. I always think of this example. Let's say I have 1 when x is greater than or equal to 0, minus 1 x is less than 0. Correct. Clearly it is discontinuous at 0, hence not differentiable at 0.
Yeah.
If I choose another function, 2 when x is greater than or equal to 0 and minus 2 when x is less than 0. This is also non-differentiable at 0 because it was discontinuous at 0. What happens when you multiply it? You get a constant function, that's minus 2. Sorry, that's plus 2. Plus 2 is always continuous in the future. Okay? And there is no domain issue also. Okay? Please check that domain issue. It should not be like, it should be in the overlapping domain. Is it right? So cannot say, and same would be also applicable if you are taking the quotient of two functions. We cannot say anything. Okay. So one question I want to ask. Is the derivative of a continuous function always continuous? Let's say a function continuous at x equal to a. Will the derivative of the function at x equal to a will always exist?
No.
Is the derivative of a function continuous at x equal to a is also continuous at x equal to a?
What? Not.
Not necessarily.
Not necessarily. Not necessarily. So please remember all these things. So now we'll take questions.